Hello everyone, I'm Rick with Cybermedics, and we're here today to discuss the water sensors from Flow, Phyn, and Yolink. In particular, I wanted to kind of go over the water sensing cables from all three vendors. And you say, well, why is that important? Well, I have the Yolink system. I haven't installed it yet, but I bought all of the sensors. And I'm particularly impressed with the technology. And if you check out my other videos, you'll see a detailed review of the overall system. However, there is one problem with the Yolink system, and that is the water sensing cable does not lay flat. Now, if you see this cable here, I don't know if you can tell it from the video, but it's kind of like a hard plastic and a wire inside of it. So it very easily, when you bend it, it keeps its position. So once you bend it, you can see that it's like that. And out of the box, this one here that I just showed you, that was actually put on a table and taped for like 5 days to keep it straight, and it's still not completely straight. But out of the box, that's what you're going to get. You're going to get a cable that looks like that. And so your ability to get that cable to lay flat is going to be challenging. Now, what I've got here is this is the water sensing cable from Phyn. And this is the water sensing cable from Honeywell. This cable costs approximately $17. This cable is crazy expensive, and it costs about $26. So what I did earlier is I checked the compatibility of the cable with the other sensors. So this Phyn cable apparently must be proprietary because it doesn't work in the Flow water valve and it doesn't work in the Yolink water valve. I checked the Honeywell cable and it works both in the Flow valve and the Yolink valve. Okay. And why am I showing you these cables? Because the difference in the Honeywell cable is that it kind of has like a cloth casing. So when you move it, it's very flexible, but it doesn't retain that position. So out of the box, this cable hasn't been taped down or anything. You can see how flat it lays. This is a cable from Yolink, like I said, that I had on a table and taped it for 5 days. And you can tell it's still isn't even close to touching the table. So while I really appreciate Yolink's technology and their capability of their smart water system, I think the cables really have an issue. They need to be made more like this. Now, what you could do is you could use this Honeywell cable. You have to pay another $17. And I understand the Yolink cable is $10, so maybe they focused on price as opposed to quality. But in the end, if the cable is not functional because it's not touching the water surface, it's absolutely useless. So you might want to consider using these. So for just a quick demonstration, what I'm going to do is I'm going to plug this in to the Yolink. And the reason it's sensing is because earlier it was actually, this cable has retained the fact that it's actually been in the water. So you can see that it alarmed the Yolink one. And this is the Moen. It actually plugs into, this is the holder for the sensor. It actually plugs into the sensor and there's little contacts on it. It may take it a minute to actually alarm. So apparently I was wrong. I have not been able to get the Honeywell cable to work with the Moen sensor. This is the probe sensor that comes with the Moen. And it works. But when I plug in the Honeywell cable and put it in the water, it's not alarming the Moen. So let's get the Yolink valve over here. Let's open it up. I think you can see that. Yep, sure can. Let's take the Yolink sensor and let's plug in the Honeywell cable. Oh, look at that. That's awesome. Nice. So the Honeywell cable will work with the Yolink water valve. And I'm telling you, that's really important because this cable lays flat. And I'm not sure if you're going to be able to trust the Yolink cables compared to the Honeywell cables. Because like I said, this is out of the box. It's not perfectly flat, but I'm thinking if you tape that out over a period of time, see that? Just doing that with it. Look at that. Although I think they could have been a little bit smarter and picked a different color other than white, because eventually laying on your floors and stuff, that's going to get ugly. At least Phyn was smart enough to make their cables black. But the other thing to keep in mind is the Honeywell cable is about a foot longer. The ones from Yolink and Phyn are both 3 feet, both 3 feet in length, and the Honeywell is four foot in length. So I hope this helps. It really helped me. I definitely will be probably using these Honeywell cables instead of the cables that come with the Yolink. These are just really difficult to get to lay flat. So if you guys have any questions or need any help, please let me know. Be great if you subscribe. You guys have a great and wonderful automation day.